Hello, in this video I will quickly talk about intermittent demand forecasting and also bootstrapping methods. So let's get into the video. First, what is intermittent demand forecasting? Intermittent demand is mostly seen in spare parts demand, and this type of demand has lots of zero values, and it is hard to do forecast in this type of demand. As I said, this type of demand has lots of zero values, so its main characteristic is low demand. Another significant characteristic of this demand type is random non-zero values. These characteristics cause large degree of uncertainty and also unpredictable fluctuations. What is the interest of intermittent demand and where is it used? It is first a time series data. Intermittent demand, you can mostly see it in manufacturing companies because you will have spare parts which has low demand, and the main characteristics of these demand types are lots of zero values with non-zero random values. So these companies mostly deal with these kind of intermittent demands. That's why it's important to be able to make forecasts for this type of demand. There are different methods used to forecast this type of demand. The first one is parametric approach, where the demand is fitted to a distribution. The other one is bootstrapping methods. The third one is machine learning models. And the fourth one is hybrid models, where different techniques are used as parametric, bootstrapping, and also machine learning models together. In this diagram, you can see different types of demands. For each demand type, you can apply different methods. To be able to understand which type of methods you should apply to certain demand types, you should refer to the mostly used articles in this field. In this video, I will talk about the bootstrapping methods. Bootstrapping methods can be used where you have a sample data and you would like to have a distribution from this sample data by resampling it. So by resampling it, you are creating a population. Then you can create a distribution. With this distribution, you can make some estimations for your demand. But there is not only one type of bootstrapping method. There are different ones, especially for intermittent demand. The most famous ones are WSS and VZ methods. And in this diagram, you can see how the bootstrapping is done by resampling from the sample and creating different samples, and then eventually creating a distribution. It is interesting to use bootstrapping methods for intermittent demand forecasting because in intermittent demand forecasting, as we have already seen, the demands are mostly zero or zero demands are really random. And let's say if you have a monthly demand data like this one, and if you would like to forecast for the next 12 months, then you should be able to make use of this 24 month of data to make a reasonable forecast. In the description, you will be able to find some of the resources that I have used to make this video. And also I will leave you some sites where you can use some already written codes to be able to run bootstrapping methods for your intermittent demand. Thank you for watching this quick video, and do not forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel and expect more videos. If you have any questions, you can drop your comments, or you can directly reach me through my social media accounts. We can discuss more on this topic and also brainstorm some research ideas. And again, thank you for watching this video and see you in the next one. Bye.